welcome back to free engineering tutorial on operating system. So in this video we are going to talk about first in first out page replacement. Okay, so first of all I want to make the question clear is that we are being given one reference string, okay, on which we have to deploy our algorithm, okay, replacement algorithm. On that string, according to this sequence, we have to come up with an answer that what are the number of page faults which we will encounter or the CPU will encounter while execution. Okay, so by deploying this algorithm, we will come to know that what are the number of page faults which operating system will encounter. Okay, so let's start the question. So first of all, seventh page will come, and as you can see that when the operating system or CPU or any process will demand the seventh page, it is not there in the page frame. Okay, so what will it do? It will demand the page. Okay, so this 7 will come. Okay, after that it will be stored in physical memory. So let's say this is the physical memory containing 3 frames. Okay, only 3 frames. Now after that it is demanding for 0th frame. Okay, so it is also not there in the physical memory. Now it will be stored in the page frame, okay, or the physical memory. After that it will demand for 1, and it is also not there in the physical memory. It will be stored in 1. Now when 2 comes, it will see that there is no room for 2, so there have to be one replacement algorithm. So what will it do? It will check which frame came first in the sequence. So as you can see that 7 came first in the algorithm or the sequence, so it will replace only that page, okay, and will store itself on the location of that page only. Okay, so now the sequence will be 201. Now as 0 came, means page 0 came, it the CPU will see that 0 is already there. Okay, so this is the moment of page hit. Okay, now after this it will see that there is a frame 3 which is being demanded by the CPU or process, but it is not there in the physical memory. So what will it do? It will replace the page which came first in the sequence. So as you can see that 0 came first in the sequence, so it will remove that 0, means replace the 0th frame, and will store itself in the location of 0. In the same way, 0 will store itself in the place of 1, as 1 came first in the sequence. Okay, after that 0 after 0 will happen, now 4 will be demanded, and it is not there in the physical memory. It will be replaced with the 2 frame. Okay, frame 2. After that 2 will come, it is also not there, so it will be stored on the place of 3, as 3 came first among 4, 3 and 0. Okay, after 2 will be executed, 3 in the same way, it will be stored in the place of 0. In the same way, as you can see that there are these hits. Okay, so where the page is already present in the physical memory, there is the condition of page hits. Okay, and if there is no page which is demanded and it is not present in physical memory, so that page will be considered as page fault. Okay, so in the FIFO page algorithm, let's consider one more example. Okay, so let's say this is the reference string. Okay, in reference string, let's say there are 3 frame physical memory. So what will it do? It will see, means the process will demand 1, and it is not there in the physical memory, so it will store 1. After that it will store 2, and in the same way it will store 3 in the physical memory. But when 4 came, it has to replace the 1 which came first in the sequence. So 4, 2, 3. Now again it will store 1 in place of 2, as it came first in the sequence. In the same way, as you can see that when we means deploy the algorithm, we will get that there are 3 page hits. So 3 page hits. Okay, and there are total 12 pages which are there in the reference string. So what will be the number of page misses or page faults? It will be 9. Okay, 9 will be the page fault. So in the place of physical memory which contain 3 frames, let's store 4 frames in the same physical memory. Then what will happen? We will get to know that it contains 10 number of page faults. Okay, so this anomaly is there, where if we have less number of page frames in the physical memory, we are getting less number of page faults. But when we are taking greater number of page frames in the physical memory, we are getting higher number of page faults. Okay, so this anomaly we had to remove, which is there in the first in first out algorithm. So we will remove this with the help of optimal page replacement algorithm, which we will study in next video. Okay, so to get these slides which I am using in these videos, you can refer to the link description of the last video of this module. From there you will get the slides. Okay, so till the next video, thank you.